Welcome to Office 2013, class video number 30. Hey, if you want to download this workbook, and this is for videos 28 to 34, click on the link below the video or go to our class website. Hey, we're still studying Excel. This is Excel Basics 12. We're going to talk about the round function. Yes, we ran into trouble at the end of last video, and we need to see when and how to use the round function in business. Now, how do we round by hand? Well, there are some different ways for rounding, but the most common way is to first look at your number. We have two numbers here, and pick the position you want to round to. So here, we want to round to the penny. So in both cases, we've selected the 2. The next is we have to look to the digit to the right. If it's 5 or bigger, we add one to the position you're rounding to and remove unwanted digits. Otherwise, if it's 4 or less, we remove unwanted digits. So in this first number, there's the blue, pick the position. Here's the number we have to look at to make our decision. It's 4 or less, so we add 0 to the position and then hack off the remaining decimal. So this number becomes 52.72. For this number here, we pick the position. We're looking at 7, so that means we have to add one. So we add one, and the 72 becomes 73, 5273. We never want to ever have to do that by hand again. Luckily, there's the round function. And all the round asks for is, hey, tell me what position, and it will do the rest. All right. So here's our example, same example as last time. We went ahead and made our calculation and copied it down in last video. We saw that because there were some extraneous decimals under the number formatting, the sum function was adding. If we were to come over here like we did in our last video and actually type what we see into the cell. This is the surface of the spreadsheet. 5858 is just what I see on top. But if I type what I see on top over here, and then also for this one here and add them up, I'm getting 163.90. If we increase the decimals here, there's the problem. 72, that extra 76, notice those are decimals past the penny. Here, that's 68. Here, that 84. All of those extra extraneous decimals are being used in the formula. So down here, we have the sum function. Sum function, if I come up here, boy, is this a common mistake on the planet Earth with people's Excel use. They're like, they decreased the decimals, and they think that it actually removed them. But nope. That sum function is looking at all those extraneous decimals. Now let's go ahead and increase them back up here because we're going to learn how to use the round function. And I want to make sure when I use the round function that they're gone. Round function is easy. We click in the cell with our calculation. And here is a small formula, right? We're just multiplying. Whatever formula it is, however big, we just got to put it inside the round function. So what do they call the function that rounds? You got it. Round. So I'm going to round, not round up or down, just the regular round. This is the regular rounding rule. The number, it can be whatever. A single cell or huge formula, it doesn't care. Come to the end and type a comma. And all the sum needs is it needs to know the number of digits. Now the way I always remember it is I count. So if I'm starting at the decimal, I'm going to go 1, 2, if that's the position I want, that's the number I'm going to use. So for pennies, you always say 2. So the rule is, or the memorization rule is, count going to the right from the decimal, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And whatever position it is, that's the number you put here. Now, if you're to the left of the decimal, well, because we went 1, 2 moving this way, we're always adding one. If you're going back the other way, you're subtracting one. So I just memorize. Penny is 2. Well, if penny is 2 and I'm going this way, it would be 2, 1, 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. All right? For pennies, right to that 9, it's a 2. For dollars, like rounding for income taxes on an income tax report where it's required that you round to the dollar or the ones position, that would be a zero. All right, so invoicing, payroll taxes where we're dealing with pennies, that's a two. Close parentheses, control enter. No longer do we have that error. Our actual formula, looking at our calculation, is adding the correctly rounded numbers. Now, of course, we would decrease those. I'm going to leave those there just for the path so we can come back later and look. Now, here's our rules for rounding. Round to the penny, the hundredths position, use a 2. Round to the dollar, ones position, use a 0. If you're rounding to the thousandths position, you'd use a minus 3. Now, this is actually the rule for the second argument in round. The rule for us in business is, when are we going to use round? When we're multiplying or dividing decimals and run the risk of extraneous decimals, and we will be using the numbers in subsequent formulas. Then we have to use round. All right, let's go look at another example. We're going to look at an invoice example. Now, here we have an invoice, but I want to add some formatting to this invoice. So I want to highlight that range right there. Go up to Home, actually Control F1 to turn that on. And I want to go to Fill and add some fill, some background fill, some light gray there or something. And then to the outside, I'm going to add a thick outside border. And then we have some areas where we're entering raw data, and then we're going to have some formulas over here. And I want some borders here, and so I'm going to use my control key to select areas that are not exactly the same size. And then I can simply click the All Borders button one time. All right, so now we want to multiply. We have price times unit. So equals price times unit. And immediately we can see this is an invoice. We're dealing with pennies. We need to round. So F2, round, come to the end. Hey, we're going to the penny, so 2. Close parentheses. Control enter. That's much better. And copy it down. Notice I have general number formatting. If I'm building something like this, I don't want to add the number formatting till the end, right? Now the subtotal. I don't need to add a round here because those numbers are already rounded. Alt equals. Enter. Taxes are another situation where you're probably going to have to use round. I don't even mess around. Once I start multiplying or dividing decimals, I'm using round. Let's go ahead and not use round and see. It's going to give us a big number there with lots of extraneous decimals. So F2, round. I'm going to use the end, E-N-D key. E-N-D jumps to the end of a sentence in Word, or if we're naming a folder when we were in Windows Explorer, that jumped to the end. Well, end also works in a formula, E-N-D key, comma 2, close parentheses, enter. All right, the keyboard for AutoSum, Alt equals. It didn't guess right, so I'm simply going to redirect it and enter. And so now we have created an invoice. We could come over here and add a currency if we wanted to. And I'm going to come up here and add something like currency or accounting. All right, so there we go. One last example. Oops, I did it again. I left these numbers here, so let's pretend they're not there. Delete. Here we have a situation where we need to multiply taxable amount times tax rate, but we're required by our tax form to round to the dollar. No problem. Round. I take the taxable amount, one cell to my left, times D47, and I'm going to hit the F4 key to lock it, comma, 0 to go to the ones position, or the dollar, close parentheses, control enter, double click and send it down. So in that case, F2 at the bottom, each one of our calculations is being rounded to the dollar. Okay, round function, very important for invoicing payroll taxes. And you want to remember, round to the penny is 2, to the dollar is 0. And when do we want to round? If you're multiplying and dividing decimals and you run the risk of extra decimals past your dollar or penny, and you'll be using the numbers in subsequent formulas, then use the round. All right, we'll see you next video.